Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to separate water from hexane. And for this experiment, I'm going to color the water so that I can show you the different layers more clearly, but you can do this with just simple water with no food coloring. So for the experiment, I'm going to use two graduated cylinders to approximate the amount of water and hexane that will go into my separatory funnel. A separatory funnel always looks like this. There is a valve on the bottom, a cap on the top, and it comes in different sizes. This one is a 125 milliliter one, and this one is a 250 milliliter one. I will go with the smaller size for today. A separatory funnel always needs to be suspended from a stand. So for today, I'm going to use a stand. And to support the separatory funnel, I will also need to use an O-ring. And to place things together, you want to have your separatory funnel in the closed position where the valve is perpendicular to the direction where the liquid would flow out, and the cap should be on top, closed. Gently lower it, and it should be completely supported by the O-ring. There should always be something on the bottom of the separatory funnel, usually a beaker where we collect our solution. Now, the tip of the separatory funnel should be below the top of the beaker, but maybe this is a little too low. To adjust the height, we would disconnect, place it, and just lower it a little bit so it doesn't splash out. Once we have our setup, now it's a matter of bringing in our materials. For today's experiment, I'm going to use some water, some hexane, and to visually separate the two layers, I'm also going to use some green food coloring that will dissolve in the water, but not in the hexane. For both water and hexane, I'm going to measure out approximately 20 milliliters and then transfer both of those into my separatory funnel. When I open up the separatory funnel, I will use my two fingers and remove the cap and hold it away from me. First, I'm going to measure out the hexane. And because I'm measuring in a graduated cylinder, I want to make sure that I'm going to be eye level with my measurement. For both the volume of water and the volume of hexane, I want to record those, but I'm not going to worry too much about that because water and hexane will evaporate at different rates as the experiment progresses. So now I'm going to remove the cap, transfer the hexane into my closed separatory funnel. And then I will transfer the water into the separatory funnel. Now I will add the one drop of food coloring. And close the separatory funnel. First thing we're going to do is shake everything so that they're nicely mixed. And because vapor can be created through the shaking process and my hand being warm, we need to release the pressure that is building up. And if you hear a little bit of a whiff, that is caused by the gas pressure that builds up. We should do this at least two or three times. And you always want to hold the cap so it doesn't accidentally pop off. And then you should always release the gas pressure. Once you're done, you gently place your separatory funnel on the top. And then you give it time to settle. The layers must be completely separated, and if you shook it a lot, you probably notice some bubbles. And in this case, between the two layers, there are bubbles that are slowly popping. When the layers are sufficiently separated, you may proceed with the separation. You can do it quite slowly. If you do that, it is going to help the separation further. First step, we remove the cap from the separatory funnel and hold it away from us. Next, we're going to very gently open up the valve and slowly and in a controlled fashion, release the lower layer. And you can see how the green layer and the clear layer are quite separated. When the interface of the layer is very close to the valve, that is where we need to slow down and make sure that we can control when to stop. And now only the clear layer is on top and the green layer is on the bottom. We successfully separated the water from the hexane. To extract the hexane, we would have to replace the beaker that's on the bottom, release a small amount that is the interface of the hexane and the water, and then bring in a clean beaker and collect the hexane that way. But until then, we put a cap on it and ready ourselves for that step.